If by Rudyard Kipling. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good, nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster, and treat those two impostors just the same. If you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings, and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose, and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And, which is more, you'll be a man, my son. Now, the beautiful truths revealed in this poem will no doubt be perfectly apparent to you, but I want to talk a little about why I think this poem is such an apt one for the alt-right. Being besieged by unstable leftists is an everyday occurrence for those of us with controversial political opinions. It takes strength, commitment, and a level head to hold and propagate the opinions we do. And we do what we do because we know it has to be done. Not because we want to be popular or rich. We make ourselves the target for the derision of others because we love something far more important than our own individual well-being. To stand firm in our beliefs is no mean feat in a world that, in the main, still despises us. To avoid getting personal and being vengeful against normies and leftists that are scared and ignorant is a virtue many of us still need to cultivate. That's not to say it's not incredibly difficult at times, but we lose credibility when we indulge in the kind of tantrums so common amongst our adversaries. Of course, people are routinely and knowingly duped by the emotionality and fakery of the left all the time, but over the long term, the truth, as they say, will out. We must never deal in deception. That's one of the biggest natural advantages that we have over the left. Our way is the way of nature, not the way of carefully concocted lies. We need to have faith that people will come to the truth and realize that the lies of the left only dig us all deeper into the multicultural mire. Patience is a virtue, and so is the ability to rise above the melee of anger and pettiness. It's also true that the smugness of the left has been its greatest downfall in recent years. Its failure to comprehend it could possibly lose has opened the floodgates to a wave of political dissent that still has it reeling. Let us never take our victory for granted or fall into the trap of pretentiousness or condescension. Let us keep working hard every day for every morsel of success we get. Let us speak from our heads as well as our hearts, and communicate in a way that engages people. Our ability to dream and imagine a better world for our people is a huge element in our movement's ability to grow and stir their collective soul. Our vision is born out of love, and our destiny is what we choose. But so too is it crucial that we never fall prey to self-delusion or the paralysis of the dreamer. The ability to deal with the world as it really is and address real problems is every bit as important as our vision of what we are working towards. We also have to acknowledge that everything changes and evolves, for better or worse. The ability to roll with the numerous punches and not lose ourselves in momentary celebration will help us maintain our readiness to take on any challenge. How many of us have had our words deliberately misrepresented by our liberal friends and family or in debates? How many times have we seen people led astray by globalist propaganda and had to watch powerless while, for example, Europe underwent the devastating migrant crisis, knowing it was all based on a vicious globalist lie? This is the stuff of every day for us on the right, but we cannot and must not give up while we still have a breath in our bodies. To destroy something beautiful is the easiest thing in the world. What makes a man is the skill and patience to build again. Sometimes difficult decisions will have to be taken in the face of uncertainty, and sometimes they won't work. Again, what counts is our resolution to learn from our mistakes and not allow ourselves to be bogged down in the memories of hard times or defeats. We take refuge in each other in this fight. We are all that we have and all we need. Playing the victim, expecting sympathy, or petty infighting never plays well with those on the outside. Plus, it's just pathetic. The ability to endure both physically and mentally when all seems lost is one of the key strengths we need as a movement. We know that we live in a world where the powers that be wish to bring about our destruction physically, morally, culturally, politically, and economically. But none of this changes the truth of what we say. Indeed, it underscores it. And it will be our ability to endure and carry the truth of our message for the benefit of future generations of our people that will make the difference between success and failure. To do this, we must have a firm grounding in our beliefs, constantly educating ourselves, and also looking after ourselves and our loved ones through exercise and proper nutrition. I have white, middle-class, leftist friends that see no irony in sneering at the white working class whilst simultaneously advocating the entry of unlimited numbers of largely illiterate people from Islamic countries whose values fundamentally oppose their own. Our ability to communicate honestly and respectfully with all people from whatever background is another natural advantage we have over the new left. We're not the sneering kind. We on the right do not see a person's worth in terms of their income or formal education. We refuse to belittle a person for being white in their own country. We do not silence people on the basis of their social group or any other characteristic. We love our people, and we see a need to defend them. But that does not imply a hatred of others. We take each individual on their merits, but recognize that the preservation of race, culture, and territory matters. If we strive to become ever closer to Kipling's vision of true manhood, we can look forward to a bright future indeed. The prize we are working for couldn't be more valuable, and this is our opportunity to prove ourselves equal to the task ahead. We cannot fail. If you hadn't heard this poem before watching this video, it's my distinct privilege in introducing it to you. If you already knew of it, I hope you see it in a new light, one that will bring it alive in a new way for you and those you love. It is surely a poem that can teach us much about how we should govern our own lives and how we can drive our movement forward. Until next time, be well.